السلام عليكم. Hello everybody. Today our video is about liver cirrhosis on ultrasound. Cirrhosis is a common endpoint of a wide variety of chronic liver disease processes, which cause hepatocellular necrosis. Cirrhosis can be diagnosed with ultrasound, CT, and MRI, and these imaging modalities can also be used to evaluate for possible complications of cirrhosis, such as portal hypertension or hepatocellular carcinoma. Ultrasound is a major screening tool for cirrhosis and its complications. It is also useful to aid for biopsy. Appearances include: number 1, surface nodularity 88% sensitive, 82 to 95% specific. Number 2, overall coarse and heterogeneous echotecture. Number 3, segmental hypertrophy and or atrophy. A caudate width to right lobe width is more than 0.65. B reduction of the transverse diameter less than 30 millimeters of the medial segment of the left lobe, segment 4. Number 4, signs of portal hypertension, which includes A. splenomegaly, B. ascites, C. fat change which is variable, D. according to Doppler flow changes. Number 1, portal venous system, enlarged portal vein more than 13 millimeters, slow portal venous flow below 15 centimeters per second, reversal or to and fro portal venous flow, portal venous thrombosis with or without cavernous transformation, enlarged superior mesenteric vein and splenic vein more than 10 millimeters, loss of respiratory variation in superior mesenteric vein and splenic vein spectral Doppler waveforms, enlarged para-umbilical vein with hepatofugal flow, portosystemic collaterals. Number 2, according to hepatic veins, portalization of hepatic vein waveform. Number 3, hepatic arteries, corkscrew appearance and increased velocity compensating for decreased portal vein flow.